guys, this is Laura from Doggy You, and I am currently in Connecticut after a quick drive out from Colorado. And today I want to talk about sleeping in parking lots, which is my main thing that I do when I'm doing a lot of fast travel, and safety related to that. So I get asked a lot where I'm sleeping in the van, and because I'm not from an area where there's a lot of BLM land in New England, there's not a lot of free camping spots, or there's not as many as there is out west, I do a lot of fast travel, and I like to get from one place to the other quickly, and when I do that, I sleep in parking lots. It's very glamorous, let me tell you. So basically, I needed to get to Connecticut in 2 days because I had to go to a baby shower. I was surprising my family, going to a baby shower. So it's about a 28-hour drive from Colorado to Connecticut, and I'm a very experienced long-range driver, so that's about 14 hours of actual driving a day, plus taking care of the two dogs at the same time. So I needed to do that in 2 days. It's a long haul, and I like to get somewhere quickly. So some people like to like drive for 4 hours, hang out in the city, drive another 4 hours the next day. I'm not like that. If I have a place to go, I want to just get there. And having a van is perfect for that because it means that whenever I get tired, I just stop driving. So if I get tired at all, I can either take a nap or pull over for the night. So where am I pulling over for the night? I am pulling over in those, they're not park and rides, they're basically like travel plazas, sort of. So it's those places where it'll say restrooms, available, and it'll be 3 miles away, and the next one's like 96 miles away. So I'm sleeping in those places. And if I had the wherewithal to tape where I slept the other night, I would have, but I didn't. So I'm sleeping in those places that come up anywhere from every 30 miles to ever 90 miles, depending on what stretch of the country you're driving through. And that's my main place if I'm doing fast travel and I don't want to have to plan out where I'm traveling, that I sleep in. And you will notice if you sleep in those places, there's a lot of people sleeping in them. So a lot of people that are coming through in their cars, they just need a quick place to sleep so that they can start driving again. Why I love those places is I don't have to plan it. I don't have to research. I know on certain stretches of highway that there's going to be rest stops like that that I can sleep in. I tend to avoid the ones with gas stations where a lot of trucks are parked. I want just like the straight up, there's a bathroom and some vending machines kind of place. So that's the really big benefit, is there's a bathroom. And as you know, there is not a bathroom in my van. I do have my trusty bucket just in case for emergencies, but I prefer to use a regular bathroom. So if I stop there, I have the opportunity to use the bathroom, use the sink, brush my teeth, all that good stuff, and sleep for the night. So I've slept in, I don't know, probably 100 of these things on my ways in various travel, and I have had zero issues with doing that so far. So let's talk a little bit about safety and how I go about being safe in those places, especially as a solo female traveler, if I'm going to sleep in one of those rest stop parking lot types of things. I do a couple things. First, my van is branded. It has magnets on it. The magnets are on purpose so that if I'm traveling alone and I'm not doing anything dog related, I can pull the magnets so that my van isn't recognizable. So that's number one. I pull those magnets before, like several hours before I'm going to stop for the night. The other thing that I do safety-wise is I don't use the facilities in the same place that I'm sleeping. I don't want anyone to know who's in the van. And part of me getting an actual van instead of a truck camper, because I did have a truck before my two vans, was that I want to make sure that I can go from the front of the van to the back of the van without having to get out of my car. I don't want anyone knowing who's in there. I don't want them to know that there's dogs in here, any of that. So what I do is before I get tired, I use the restroom at a different place than I'm sleeping, okay? So no one's gonna see, when I roll up for the night to sleep, no one's gonna see who's in the van. So I use the bathroom, I walk the dogs, I let them go to the bathroom in a different spot than I'm actually sleeping. When I do use the restrooms, because it's typically gonna be late at night, there may or may not be people in the parking lot, I don't know who's there, I do bring my stun gun with me. So I have a stun gun that I carry in the car for traveling alone, and for this purposes, it looks like a flashlight. So I bring that with me into the bathroom if I need to. Another big tip for people who are feeling uncomfortable, going into someplace alone at night, is I use the bathroom that is the family bathroom if they have it. It's really much safer to use the family bathroom because you don't have to see if there's anybody else in the bathroom, anything like that. You can go in, brush your teeth, do all that kind of stuff in that one single bathroom, and it makes me feel a little safer if that's an option. So once I've gone to the bathroom and used the facilities and walked my dog in that new in the new place, then I drive on to the next place that I'm going to actually sleep. So you need to do this with enough notice that you're gonna be tired that you can have the wherewithal to do this. So I use the facilities in another place. I go to the next place that I'm gonna sleep, and as soon as I get there, I shut everything off. I put up all of my window covers so nobody can see in the van, and then I turn on my lights. So this is just something that I do for my personal safety because I do travel alone so much. Then I also have my dogs, right? And I think traveling with a dog is a really good idea for a female traveler if you can handle all the responsibility and the difficulties that comes with traveling with a dog. But I have an early warning system. One of my dogs, if someone gets near the van, will get up and notify me that someone's near the van. I find that incredibly useful, and it just gives me that extra feeling of safety. But again, I have had no issues at any of the rest stops that I have slept in, and some of them are super nice. And it's just a nice thing to be able to pull in, put up all of your shades, and go to sleep whenever you feel like it. I've also slept in other types of parking lots. Like, I really like sleeping in Cabela's parking lots or Bass Pro Shops, which do allow sleeping. I always call beforehand and ask them and make sure that that's okay to do. And then I'll just park there and sleep. Now, the downside of that is I typically drive till late at night. I could be driving until 11 o'clock at night. They're not open. There's no bathroom there. So you do need to know that you need to use the facilities elsewhere. Park the van, but then you're usually by yourself in the parking lot, which I love. Nice and quiet, easy to find. There's a lot of Cabela's on main highways, so that works out well. Great place to sleep. I know some people sleep in like Walmart parking lots or Cracker Barrels and that kind of thing. That's not really for me. I like the park and rides better, and I like the Cabela's parking lots better. So if you enjoy fast travel, definitely try sleeping in a parking lot. Maybe, you know, bring someone with you the first time if you're a little uncomfortable about it. Use those tips for safety, making sure that your van is unmarked. If you have a dog, bring it with you. If you have a means of protection, I also bring that with me as well. And I don't sleep in the same place that I use the facilities. And that tends to keep me pretty darn safe after, in the last couple years, I've done 60,000 miles or so of solo travel. So, check that out. Use those tips and let me know what you guys do to keep safe and where you guys are sleeping on the road if you don't have the option of camping or BLM land. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video and want more content, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. We do new videos every single week on van stuff and dog stuff and all sorts of travel and that kind of thing. So if you have any questions, comment below. I answer all of my comments as long as they're not mean. That's about it. I'm gonna go hang out with my family. You guys have an awesome day and happy travels.